Welcome to another segment of Revolution Television's 528 Hollywood Spin Series. I'm Sherry Kane.
And I'm Dr. Leonard Horowitz. And in this program, we are going to critique the latest efforts by the networks and media investigators exposing the world's most powerful propaganda and population persuasion being abused by intelligence agencies, according to Edward Snowden's leaked information.
In this segment, you will learn that so-called Americanism involving crisis capitalism is engineered by intelligence agents and agencies, including the CIA and National Security Agency, the NSA, to control every American, patriot or not. Masses don't realize they are being controlled or have fallen into hypnotic trance states. Certainly patterns of damaging behavior based on brainwashing and social engineering techniques carried by media messages promoting precisely what profits disease controllers, war makers, energy industrialists, and multinational bankers.
In this show, we're going to analyze more than Russian propaganda recently broadcast by RTTV, previously known as Russia Today, funded by the Russian federal government, in a show called Big Brother Watch, hosted by Abby Martin, who did an outstanding job reporting on the Anglo-American population persuasion agencies, including what we have been exposing most assertively for years, the FBI's counterintelligence program, or COINTELPRO.
Well, thanks to a newly released Edward Snowden document by journalist Glenn Greenwald, we now know some of these comments probably aren't coming from members of the general public at all. In an article titled, How Covert Agents Infiltrate the Internet to Manipulate, Deceive, and Destroy Reputations, Greenwald outlines how intelligence agencies use online troll tactics to influence real-world outcomes. The documents were obtained by Greenwald from the UK's NSA counterpart, GCHQ, and its uber-secretive Joint Threat Research Intelligence Group Unit, or JTRIG. See, JTRIG's mission is to destroy the reputation of specific targets by both releasing false and damning information about them and manipulating cyber conversations to affect public perception. And this program goes way beyond just posting nasty comments, guys. According to the top secret slides, which were shared with intelligence agencies in the US, Australia, Canada, and New Zealand, JTRIG employs tactics such as honey trapping, where online affairs are created for blackmail purposes, changing the target's photos on social networking sites, writing blogs, pretending to be a victim of the target, and even emailing and texting incriminatory messages to the target's friends and colleagues.
Abby Martin rightfully expressed her personal contempt for the agents and agencies acting as internet trolls, called hacktivists, trained by Britain's mass media mind manipulator, the Government Communication Headquarters, or GCHQ, in London, controlling the Joint Threat Research Intelligence Unit, or JTRIG, that trains and activates internet trolls, such as the ones Dr. Horowitz and I have been attacked by for several years. The subject covers the ways and means that government intelligence agencies use to collect and direct human intelligence, or more often, deception and ignorance, swaying public opinions to promote profits by multinational corporations feeding on war economies.
This malicious and damaging application of behavioral science also discredits certain targets by defrauding consumers, abusing people's minds, frightening people into compliance with political agendas. The media is obviously committing mind control under government control, influencing thoughts and people's actions over the internet, especially social networking blogs, including the ones in which many of our friends and colleagues, independent media personalities like Michael Vera, Howard Nima, and other legitimate truthers, have been repeatedly smeared for years. Now, we finally have evidence from official leaked government reports that the Frank Church Commission's findings that the COINTELPRO is alive and well after supposedly being terminated in the 1970s, and it's all operating in cyberspace through actions concealed by hacktivists.
As we personally experienced with the Utah counterintelligence agent Dr. Truat and company, who manufactured a so-called sex tape to extort Dr. Horowitz to give up his professional association with humanitarian organizations threatening the medical paradigm and the World Health Organization. These secret agents of deception are trained in methods called honey trapping. This includes manufacturing online sexual affairs for blackmail and harassment, creating fake profiles with fake photos to befriend targets and their friends on social networking sites, and creating blogs to discredit and or blame targets in order to flip the reality of the situation. Some agents control nearly a dozen e-aliases used to deceive and discredit activists, whistleblowers, financial targets, corporate heads, judges, and politicians. JTRIG used a packet flood operation dubbed Rolling Thunder to frighten away 80% of anonymous internet chat room users. The most common and powerful control methods is to seduce people by leveraging their greed for bribes, payoffs, or commercial benefits. These bribes and extortions get victims to attack and destroy businesses, especially undesired competitors. And these illegal acts are being used to control more than these targets. General consumers worldwide are hoodwinked so that only the strong survive. In this case, the major corporations, including Google and the major media networks and press services that are likewise controlled and aiding and abetting this racketeering enterprise. The denial of service on key communication outlets is also proven by these documents to be a government psyops. This includes controls over YouTube, Google search engine fixing and blocking, and Wikipedia's blatant bias and censorship favoring the NSA, CIA, and British government interests. I know that your popularity on the internet has been heavily suppressed by such censorship and cyber controls, hasn't it, Dr. Horowitz?
Yes, Sherry. I've had a number of legal battles with Google, YouTube, and also Wikipedia. It doesn't allow me to correct the biases and blatant mistakes made on my own Wikipedia page. I've recorded how Google suppresses statistics to aid and abet concealed special interests, which is a form of consumer fraud. I was set up by these government agents' false reports of copyright infringements, prompting YouTube to suspend my feature-length film upload privilege. So I have seen the results of this cybercrime and consumer fraud personally. My experience is corroborated also by the leaked reports by Snowden and the social engineering and mass mind control that's been now revealed. As a behavioral scientist, I can tell you how these hacktivists are destroying far more than faith in governments internationally. And that is a main agenda best explaining the Snowden and WikiLeaks. This evidence proves a program for population persuasion, deception, and manipulation that is the most sophisticated social engineering enterprise ever developed and practiced in Earth's history.
But I will admit that there's another side of the coin which I recently experienced firsthand after talking about countries and corporate powers that profited from Nazi Germany and the Holocaust. The racist, anti-Semitic, and neo-Nazi comments flooded my YouTube and social media sites in uniform, honestly making me wonder if the effort was part of a larger coordinated campaign to discredit this show. And unfortunately, it's not just countries that are responsible for contributing to the growth of toxic online dialogue. It's corporations, too. As revealed in Breaking the Set by investigative journalist Dar Jamel, BP used PR firm Ogilvy & Mather to hire online trolls to attack and bully individuals who complain about the company's response to the Deepwater Horizon oil spill. And we'd have to be naive to think that most multinational corporations aren't copying this exact technique of controlling their online image. After all, that's just 21st century PR.
Sherry, I've experienced this kind of betrayal and traitorous activity since 2007 as a leading drug industry whistleblower. And I was personally and commercially damaged by this counterintelligence protection racket for Big Pharma. Thanks to our investigations into the COINTELPRO, I finally woke up to what is really going down, an international organized criminal conspiracy to defame me for commercial gain by competing companies serving the global cartels, the mob that has effectively controlled healthcare, energy, and the financial world to suppress low-cost, no-risk, natural solutions to our planet's worst problems. For example, infectious diseases can be naturally prevented and remedied by OxySilver, the world's most advanced, potent, broad-spectrum antimicrobial that makes all antibiotics and damaging vaccinations obsolete. That's why the COINTELPRO, now called hacktivists, attacked my reputability to destroy OxySilver and the companies that distribute it.
Now, this business of honey trapping extends beyond sexual innuendos to even manufacturing sex tapes, to blackmail and harass targets, and even extorting professionals to give up their companies and associations by destroying reputations and consumer confidence in their products. All the social networking sites are infiltrated with these government double agents and traitors to the world's free economy. Here, for example, are photographs posted on social networking sites purposely confusing people's identities and defaming victims of this organized crime. And that's not all. Fake blogs are being posted all the time by the COINTELPRO, including many purporting to be victims of this cyber defamation. Agents are assigned to act like victims of their targets. For instance, we had one government agent defame us in blogs, claiming he was harmed by the 528 frequency, which is completely ridiculous since that frequency vibrates at the heart of sunshine, snowflakes, the best of life, and pure love. The positive result of listening to 528 music is why war industrialist assign the FBI's leading West Coast propagandists, Michael Aquino and Ted Gunderson, to attack us for delivering the same message that killed Jesus and John Lennon, for spreading love and giving peace a chance.
Another agent actually came to our health spa in Hawaii, calling himself Boston Kane, knowing I'm from Boston and work with Sherry Kane. He quickly started to defame us in our community and then internationally on the internet, using perverted sexual innuendos and claims that 528 frequency music damages people when in fact it heals people.
The Patriot community has been heavily targeted by this multinational corporation protection, child sex trafficking, and deception racket, including the conspiracy con gang that produces annual conspiracy theory events, videos, and films. The entire conspiracy industry is made up of mostly government con artists who divert from the real conspiracies and realities and discredit themselves and truth tellers to create and control the intelligence in this field.
World War III for the minds of America's masses. A friend of mine and I have been working on this for a period of years. Initially, when I met him, he was head of the FBI in Los Angeles. He had been head of the FBI in Dallas and Memphis, an agent for 27 and a half years. He was a friend of my mother's, and well, my mother, though a wonderful, wonderful woman, was quite naive, and I didn't have a great deal of respect for the FBI, as I called it. So Ted at that time didn't become a close personal friend. He is now. Oh, I'm talking about Ted Gunderson, the man that has joined with me in many ventures, from Area 51 to conversations about the privately owned Federal Reserve System.
Many of these conspiracy con agents look and act like nuts and psychologically fractured, with their wild eyes and dark energy surrounding them. They never offer viable solutions to urgent problems, only regurgitate more fear-based messages. Much of what they say is so far-fetched, they become discreditable propagandists. This is best demonstrated by the video production team of Deborah Tavares, Anthony J. Hilder, and Alma C. Ott, the fake Dr. Truot.
In that's the organization that we're talking about, involving Shelley Kane, Sherry Kane, and Lynn Horowitz. She was working amongst them, closely aligned with them. Is it a Zionazi type organization? Well, certainly, the operation wasn't done by Americans. Was done by those in control of whatever activity these people wanted to do, and that was to knock off the right wing or the conservatives and patriots amongst us. Knock off the right wing or the conservatives and patriots amongst us. And that would include you. Yes, Lou and you. and the entire group, and including Truat and company.
They had actually created a sex tape that I was blackmailed with by my ex-wife to have her take over both affiliate program as well as our general corporations, converting our properties, converting all of the company's assets. And we're still in litigation with that situation.
The so-called sex tape was fed to the doctor's family, including his children, by these agent provocateurs, including what many judge as the voice of Deborah Tavares, as a so-called truther, an advocate for We the People, who I have had as a guest on my show. So imagine how surprised I was. I had also recognized Tavares' voice from interviews she had done with Power Hour host Joyce Riley.
That is the website where we have many of the breaking news and government documents that we've just revealed in the last couple of weeks.
Kane recognized her voice from an interview she watched featuring Hilder and Ott.
To the best of my knowledge, I have never met Truat in my life. I don't recall meeting Truat in my life. Shelley Kane, or Sherry Kane, or whatever her name is.
So many recognitions here. Then Sherry began investigating Tavares and discovered her audio and video productions had been promoting Hilder and Truat's propaganda.
This is Trevor Coppola for Anthony J. Hilder. I'm with Deborah Tavares, and we're going to discuss a few topics here.
Thank you.
With her husband, Lou.
Lou, I guess you know who you are. Deborah, and I don't have a last name, and James Bennett.
Yeah, I'd like to speak in support of Mr. Haggerty over here when he mentioned the vote of the people. And I'd like to remind you that California is a constitutional republic. So a vote of the people should be the first option in how this whole thing gets decided.
And individuals, the conservative or patriotic world movement, are suspects. Maybe Barbara Tavares has been one. She's a suspect. And all of these individuals are supposed to be the bad guys.
When you call me on the phone, I never met Anthony until just yesterday.
Oh, so this is your first visit?
And we've talked on the phone. He's called me when this whole lawsuit, insanity, came up. But the first time I just knew him from his pictures, and I said said hi to you yesterday.
And I never met seen him before. Or met him.
Nor have I ever met Sherry Kane. I don't know who she was either. But
have you ever met her?
No.
No, you haven't.
Don't ever want to either, frankly. I don't think I'd want
She's
that.
She's something else. When she was up there on that panel the year before last, and Anthony was up there, it was unbelievable. Yeah. She and Horowitz sitting up there.
This group claims that I damaged the entire truth movement, when in fact that's precisely what Ott and company were officially assigned to do under the FBI's COINTELPRO operation, directed by Ted Gunderson, a subordinate to J. Edgar Hoover.
We previously reported on this group with Late Night in the Midlands host Michael Vera, and all of us took flack from Dr. Truat and company's blog trolls. But now this new evidence from leaked secret government documents corroborate our earlier reports, and much more emerging evidence that government propagandists are trained to affect consumer fraud, commercial crimes at taxpayer expense. This pot of cyberbullies is always calling the kettles black while working covertly with Western intelligence agencies. They use classic effective deception called double-sided messages, well studied in the behavioral sciences. For example, Truat refers to the condemning convicted racist terrorist, Hal Turner, who served as an FBI informant at the same time he was assigned to threaten and discredit judges and politicians.
And we talked about, we had Ted Gunderson on the show at times, trying to figure out who's the good guys, who's the bad guys, who's who's who in the zoo is what we called it, because it's hard to tell sometimes, you know, with Hal Turner and that madness coming out too.
But viewers automatically think, since Ott brought up Turner, Ott couldn't possibly be guilty of doing the same things that Turner was convicted of doing. But just the opposite is true. Ott operates for the government as a neo-Nazi Christian identity freak, spreading anti-Semitism and white hate to promote cultural divisions and social unrest. Very profitable for gun makers and warmongers.
He's a man with a message, trying to appeal to our very worst instincts.
No more savage black crime!
Hal Turner markets his message of hatred at white supremacist rallies and on his internet radio show.
Welcome to the Hal Turner Show.
I say publicly what most folks already know and think.
Turner is the latest in a long list of extremists who have played to fear and ignorance. People like David Duke, formerly of the Ku Klux Klan.
White revolution!
Tom Metzger, a neo-Nazi.
But we're racist, and we make no apology for it.
George Lincoln Rockwell, the founder of the American Nazi Party.
Jews are behind it and have financed it.
And Father Charles Coughlin, who in the 1930s used the airwaves to preach anti-Semitism and fascism.
Drive the money changers from the temple, and you did it!
They have laid the groundwork for Turner and his contemporaries.
Brown-skinned animals!
Turner says his racist beliefs were born when Republican voters in New Jersey passed him over as a congressional candidate in favor of a Latino woman.
I am being discriminated against because I'm white.
So you're bitter.
I am offended that the culture that developed and built and paid for this country is now being put at the back of the bus, so to speak. Because for some reason or another, all these lower cultures and lower races are more important. And I find that disgusting.
Turner's become a master at knowing how far he can push the envelope.
Turner is very aware of precisely where the First Amendment ends. So that, you know, he can say things like, it would be a good thing. Wouldn't it be nice if some judges, some more judges were murdered? But he's quite careful as a general matter not to say, kill that judge.
It's no surprise that virtually all hate groups have become masters of the internet, although we have no way of knowing how many or how few people Turner actually reaches.
You're going to see a lot more of this in the United States.
Dr. Horowitz, these covert operatives also function to take down entire companies. Can you tell us about how you ended up losing your companies to these hacktivist dirty tricks?
Sure, Sherry. I had a very successful business operation in northern Idaho and an ex-wife who was very concerned that we weren't making enough money. She was very susceptible to being infiltrated, and that's exactly what the Church Congressional Investigating Committees found was routine. Essentially, these cyber criminals, in this case, had infiltrated my companies, my staff, my ex-wife's brain.
But JTRIG doesn't just stop at sabotaging specific individuals online. The unit also employs tactics for taking down entire companies. These tactics include leaking confidential business information to other corporations or the press, posting negative information on online forums, and getting involved in business deals to ruin relationships. And just in case JTRIG's agents are still confused about what their mission exactly is, another site explicitly states that the whole purpose of the program is, quote, using online techniques to make something happen in the real or cyber world. All of this is summed up in the catchy slogan of the four Ds, deny, disrupt, degrade, and deceive.
We're concerned that even my children were affected by the propaganda. And all these matters are outrageous, and you can't even believe that they actually took place. But in fact, that is exactly what has taken place. The leaked records show the Lords of Misrule administer demonic conditioning for war and plague commerce. They are controlling and degenerating everything that is good about life on Earth. And no one is free of this influence because of the massive destructive effect on every culture of this mind control and social engineering. Everyone is enslaved to a false reality conjured up by the oligarchy's cryptocracy, often referred to as the Illuminati.
Here, for example, you have the world's most advanced intelligence agencies blatantly admitting they control each nation's culture and every religious group like a commercial brand. Do you love your brand? Says the head of the GCHQ in Human Sciences, as he's asking his audience of secret hacktivists embarking to control audiences, markets, and civilization, and people simply follow whatever they are directed to believe or do due to the herd mentality and the absence of media focus on real modern-day heroes.
Sherry, I know that you hold a different view than most journalists about controlled opposition and Julian Assange. Would you care to comment on Peter Zatko's publication about Assange's initial funding by the National Security Agency, supporting your view that Snowden and WikiLeaks is simply two more layers of deception, creating controlled opposition as a protection racket against people seeing the bigger picture of population control? Zatko is recognized as a top-level government hacker, a Google researcher, and advisor to DARPA, who testified before the Senate in 1998 that he could bring down the internet in 30 minutes. Do you believe these people are on the level?
In my opinion, all of these revelations, because of their widespread coverage by the mainstream media, indicates controlled leaks for controlled opposition and controlled transition into the long-planned New World Order. WikiLeaks and these shocking national security leaks by Assange and Snowden are controlled leaks for global governance, engineering a new paradigm in social control for one commercially unified civilization profiting multinational corporations. Evidence for this includes the fact that you, Dr. Horowitz, with your brilliant paradigm-shattering revelation of the real Da Vinci Code and the perfect circle of sound, completing the original solfeggio musical skill frequencies now impacting medicinal music making and recording artistry internationally, has been purposely censored by the mainstream media so that your messages, no matter how important, never get widespread coverage like what we are witnessing here.
When I'm feeling weak and my pain walks down one-way street, I look above and I know
Also, the mainstream media's coverage of WikiLeaks and Snowden's leaks is extremely superficial, certainly obviously generating controlled opposition. For instance, you, as a Harvard-trained behavioral science and media persuasion expert, Dr. Horowitz, are reporting on the deadliest, most demonic control schemes certified by the leaked evidence, not mentioned by the press, which discredits the obvious intelligence service control behind the media. Further indicating a helter-skelter scheme of organized crime, Zatko, arguably the Western world's most dangerous intelligence asset, as the leading DARPA U.S. military hacktivist and propagandist, holds membership in the anti-cult Cult of the Dead Cow, that like Hollywood spins much of your work, Dr. Horowitz, including your mad cow disease thesis, in your book, Death in the Air, Globalism, Terrorism, and Toxic Warfare. You can see this evidence in The Cult of the Dead Cow, mocking the Centers for Disease Control by the initial CDC throughout their advertising, including their campaign, smearing Whole Foods, sale of buffalo meat. Here, the Zatko's Cult of the Dead Cow, satanic branding, sources from the sacred cross, an ancient Hebrew symbol of mankind, flipped over, indicating malicious control, desecrated by the skull and bones of the secret society's satanic symbol, the Baphomet.
Indeed, flipping symbols to conceal underlying agendas is a major part of population control games. Also, evidence repeatedly from Hollywood. Here, as we have been covering in segments of our Hollywood Spin movie reviews, controlling opposition for commercial gain is the name of the game in media management of the population. Another great example of how Hollywood plays this game is evidenced by the synchronous release of the film Nonstop, starring Liam Neeson, and the curiously missing Malaysian aircraft. Nonstop is a story about an air marshal who gets framed by intelligence agency agents working for multinational corporations in the security sector. These intelligence officials aid and abet financial terrorists seeking to expand the air travel security industry. The film and message is curiously most timely, being synchronous with the Malaysian jet suddenly disappearing and threatening international security by posing the threat of a possible nuclear strike by so-called terrorists with wings.
The FBI, the White House, and Interpol are confirming reports that an international flight has been hijacked by an air marshal.
Agent Marks, our fighter escort has you in their sight. Do you hear me?
We're running out of time. Do you hear me?
Hijack is planned. I'm trying to save it.
Dr. Horowitz, I know that Hollywood has stolen a lot of your research and published books and spun your intellectual properties and intelligence into movies such as The X-Files, I Am Legend, The Inception Movie, and Steven Seagal's The Patriot. How do these new revelations about the super hackers working for Western governments relate to your work?
Well, Sherry, just take a look at this slide by the cult of the dead cow and notice the infant is plugged into high technology to generate money as a form of population control. And reflect on my Death in the Air book's full-color gallery of art by famed neo-Nazi artist Edward Kleinholz, presenting a similar theme of infanticide to control populations using nuclear weapons, or alternatively, in another Kleinholz art piece, black and white infants torn by racism. Notice even the apparent relationship between this image on the head of the goat, Skull and Bones, and Kleinholz's art. The same theme is played over and over again in an art form about which the general public remains clueless, incapable of seeing the art for what it actually is saying or doing, and thereby incapable of making an informed choice about whether we want this population manipulation to be continued, especially in the hands of intelligence agencies working for multinational corporations, tricking people as they are doing with their hypnomedia.
Dr. Horowitz, I know you were shocked when you saw the last slide in the government's online covert action accreditation program. An official presentation by the head of human science for JTRIG's Human Science Operations Cell. Can you tell us about that slide?
JTRIG's presentation ends with an image and quote by Raymond Teller of the Las Vegas magical comedy team of Penn and Teller about, quote, conjuring with information, end quote, or intelligence as he peers mysteriously through his fingers. How appropriate that they ended the covert action training program with this message. That is precisely the same and most important message from Teller with which I ended the documentary film Pharmahores, the Showtime sting of Penn and Teller. The message is clear and simple. The population is being magically defrauded by agents of deception and diversion for commercial gain by multiple racketeering and organized crime enterprises regulating the major industries illegally in violation of antitrust laws prohibiting unfair competition, monopolies over industries including energy and medicine, and consumer fraud to profit those industries aided and abetted by government intelligence agencies and bribe regulators. In essence, that's the nature of this beast that has its deadly grip squeezing civilization's throat. We need a supernatural miracle, Sherry, to get us out of this hypnotic trance state induced by the intelligence agencies and the mess made by them for the multinational corporate elite. And that miracle, according to my studies and findings, is the 528 hertz frequency of medicinal music that plays to people's hearts and not their heads, and prompts the alternative to fear and spiritual suppression and social slavery. That alternative is love, faith, and freedom.
Well, that's it for another segment of Hollywood Spin, this time focusing on the media's affair with Edward Snowden, Julian Assange, and the intelligence agencies that control more than you will ever know. I'm Sherry Kane.
And I'm Dr. Leonard Horowitz. Thanks for joining us.